Hi guys, this is Noe Stufa. So today we're going to review the Unmann Packend Compression Individual EPA Type 2 from the German Defense Force or Army, which is the Bundeswehr. Yes, this will be a selection of dinner menu. So what we have here, we have the crackers, and we also have the bread with the main dishes, which is goulash with potatoes, which is beef with potatoes, and then this one with the chocolate. Here is the coffee. Oh, not good coffee. This is autotoxic favorite drinks, which will be my drinks today. And also here is a group of spread. So this one, the vegetarian spread, which I don't know what exactly it is. And this one will be the not quite sure, but this should be the sausage or ham sort of thing, the spread, meat spread. And also this one will be the sour cherry, which is the fruit spread. So we're going to boil this, but first we're going to boil this up and we're going to take a look at the other rest of the things. So first we're going to start with the sealed bread. So nutrition fact, I do believe we can read it. But anyway, we have a day cook here. This is 2010, September 24th. So probably around 5 years ago, 6 years ago. But I think it's okay because it's sealed it. So let's open it and see what we have inside. So this is sealed it, easy open tape. Very interesting actually. Let's see, can we find another way out? Actually no. Okay, so here you go. Okay, just opened. Yeah. Okay, is it right way? Okay. This is it. Very easy pull out. Smells pretty nice actually. Smell a strong flavor of the oatmeal. It still smells like oatmeal. The oat flavor is very strong. Let's put it out. This should be full oat bread. So we cannot break it because this is actually spread into few pieces. So so here we go. Let's put three in here first. So it seems around. It seems like to be a round sort of bread. And it contains a bit water, so it's a bit wet in my hand. But it looks like it looks like those hamburger, you know what I'm saying? It really looks like them, but I think it's gonna be taste nice and maybe taste a bit sour taste because of the oat flavor. But I don't know. But anyway, next one will be the Hacktackers, which is biscuits or similar things. So we have a day cook here. This one was produced in 2011, November 07. So a year later than this one. So we can see that the whole Inman pack was actually packaged in a very variety of time. So very interesting. So they are, yeah, not right like the American MRE. They also almost put us in a short period within a month or 2 months. So it's very interesting thing to observe. So anyway, let's crack in to see what they have inside. Okay, we are closing in. It's kind of hard to open. Okay, here we go. Like the normal solder biscuits. I mean, those. Okay, here we go. We got a few of them, but let's have them. see how it is like first. Okay, so this is half of them, like the normal crackers. Very normal crackers, just like what it is. So this is the bread we have today. So we're going to take a look of the other side dishes. So let us first start with this one, the Nutella or similar, what kind of thing, I don't know what it is actually, but let's open it, see how it is like. So it's 25 gram, production day is 2010 oak again, so it's February. So yeah, let's see what it is exactly. I think it's good enough. Can we pull it out? It seems no, can't, but yes we can now. So it's kind of wet, a kind of, I don't know, it's a, sounds like some kind of salad sauces, I think. I don't know. Well, let's take a taste of it. It was hard to describe. Not much flavor actually, but the crackers we have today have a very nice flavor. So it's a bit sweet, like the real cracker, and very crunchy. I love the texture of it. So yeah. So after finishing the vegetarian spread, let's just start with other spreads. This is after the vegetarian cheese one. Here will be the two other spread we have here is sour cherry. This one will be the beer wish, which is it's kind of sausage spread. So let's start with this one. And what we have here will be Deco 2011 05 10, so it's 2011, which is kind of new in this pack. Of course, just in this bag. So let's open it, see what we have inside. Okay, just prevent like last time. I hope nothing leak out. I hope. Okay, come on. Yes. Okay, so nothing really leak out this time. It smells like meat. Seems pretty nice. Let's get a taste. Okay, just cut a little bit out. With the bread here, it's good. Okay, just cut a little bit out with the bread here. Let's see how it would be tasting like. Compared with the last liver one, this one is more solid meat taste. It's quite good, but both of them are really good. After the meat spread, let's take a taste of this sour cherry. Production day stamp as 2010 July. So let's open it, see how it's like. Okay. Seems quite nice. You can see it was more like not really solid like the apical that we had last time. So let's take a taste of it with the biscuit we have. Okay, this one do contain a bit fruit on it. Comparing with the what's that called? The apical we have last time. This one is more like the to be sour, and but in the meantime a bit less flavor than we have last time, so which is not bad, obviously not really bad, which is actually good too. So they have their own signature tastes, which is good. And so that's will be the spread we have today. And here we go, the sweet, I mean the sour kind of dessert after lunch will be. After dinner will be the stock of chocolate day, which is chocolate, of course. Stay cooked here, and let's open it, see how it is. Looks like. Okay, so we have opened it up. Very strong smell of chocolate. 45% chocolate. Very, very strong taste, and it's really good. Let's pour them out. Can we do so? Okay, here we go. Let's pour them all out. No, maybe just like this first. Well, yeah, really strong flavor of the chocolate. We can take a look. I was expecting it into a World War II shape, but this is also okay. So this is the chocolate. Let's take a taste of part of it. Yeah. So this is chocolate. Pretty normal. Just like a normal chocolate. Okay. Well, the chocolate tastes quite good. Quite not really sweet, but with the, you know, what kind of taste is that? Kind of chocolate flavor, of course. Not really milk taste, but not so too, not really too, what is that called? Not really have the taste of a chocolate, but in the meantime, quite good. Well, the chocolate is actually quite good. It's very strong flavor of chocolate, and in the meantime, not really hard to eat. So that's my comment on it. So let's take a look of the beverage powder we have in this dinner, which will be the exhaustic, I think. Yes, we saw that in the UK rations. So same brand, I think the same production. I think it's produced by Germans, just like last time. I don't know, maybe. But anyway, it's J. Coke 2010. November 22. So it's set to be used 400 mm with one beverage. So yeah, got a cup here. Again, beer bottle cup. Around 100 mm. So let's pour it in and see how it's like. Okay, oh shit, too much thing leak out. Okay, give it a nice stir. Okay, finally mixing done. Take a bit time because you know, the powder was stick to in pieces, so it's kind of hard to mix it good. But as I remember, the color is a bit different from the last time of the in the UK rations. It was green, but this time it's yellow. So I don't know, would it taste a bit different? Let's try. This one tastes more like a lemon. Lemon taste, I think, maybe, but actually quite good to me. And yeah, so this we have here will be the all we have today on the dinner menu, on the dinner selection of the German EPA. So let's take a look for the main dish. So I have a main dish here, Gulasch Mint Carbonate, which is the, I'm not sure is the right pronounce, but this will be the Gulasch with potatoes. So it's quite nice. Let's open it, see how that's like. Can we pull it out this time? I don't think we can. No, we can actually this time, but we have to use some forces in order to put this away first. Can we? Yeah, we can. Yes, we can, but isn't plastic glue in here? That's sort of interesting. So we have to cut it first, so then we can have it. So this one seems to be quite nice, but really different from the last one. Last one is solid rice. This time will be a more like a, yeah, you can see like this, like it sauce things. Okay, so it's kind of hard to pull out, but I'll try my best not to lick it, not to make it lick out, not to make it pull all over the table. So give me some time, my friends. Oh god, come on, almost there, so close, come on, yeah. Alright, here we go. Okay, so what we have here will be the gulax with it's a gulax with potatoes. So it seems quite nice, I think. Let's pull them out in dishes in the plate. Yeah, well, actually nice. But I would suggest to eat with some kind of spaghetti or some kind of, well, in the village, Asian, give me some rice. This would be great with it. Okay, so here we go. Let's take a look. How the thing, oh, leak out. Okay, so, well, it seems quite good, I think, to me. Okay, let's take a look. Of it. Oh, you can see the potatoes here. Ah, leak again. Sorry, but too messy. There's the potato here. Let's take a taste of them. Let's go taste. Quite soft. Quite still very fresh, in my opinion. And we take a look of the beef with goulash. Okay. Well, to be honest, the beef is a bit overcooked, but it's still okay. Well, and also the sauce of the goulash is a bit tomato taste, but a bit like what we have in the British menu, with the early breakfast, the texture of them, the flavor of them, like the tomato bean. I mean, that kind of thing. In my opinion. So anyway, this will be it. The German EPA Innmannpacken Type 2, my dinner selection menu. So end of the German EPA ration series. Hope you like this video. Hit like if you did. Subscribe, have a lot. And I'm noise too far. I'll see you next time.